townhouse for $125,000. That's worth $1.25 million now. And that was on a $12,000 investment. Welcome to part three of my How to Invest series. The first video was on the best investment in America. Part two was on investing in the stock market and cyber currencies. This is on investing in real estate, where I have most of my experience and most of my success since I have lost my shirt and everything else. So let's talk about real estate as an investment. Real estate has some really important advantages that most people overlook. Let's contrast that to stocks. So you own stock in a company. If that company goes belly up, how much do you have? Zero. Correct. You lose it all. On the other hand, say you own a house and there's a hurricane or an earthquake. Yep, you lost your house. The thing is, you still own the land, and depending on where you are, that is a huge chunk of the value. Around here in California, it is more than 75% of the value. What's sitting on the lot is not relevant. It's the land that is worth the money. So that's the first advantage of real estate. The second advantage of real estate is similar to the one I mentioned in the stock market. So if you look at long-term trends of the stock market, they go up. There's some corrections, some crashes. Same with real estate. There's been some corrections, but overall, it does equal or better to the stock market in most places. Notice I said most places. We'll talk about that later. It's location, location, location. Places in Detroit have become worthless in some neighborhoods. There's no jobs, they're boarded up, they're bulldozed, the land is worth zero. So, but back to the advantage of real estate is the market is going up. With real estate, you cannot time the market. It's something that's very difficult and slow to get into and very difficult and slow to get out of. So you're forced to hold through the good times and the bad times. What this does is it prevents the market timing, which means you do great because you can't screw up. You just hold for the long term. So the fact that real estate's so hard to sell keeps you from doing stupid things like panic selling. The third advantage of real estate is even more exciting. So when you buy stock, if you have $1,000, how much stock can you buy? $1,000. Nobody's gonna loan you money to buy stock, no one in their right mind. Real estate is different. Typically, it's 20% down, sometimes 10%, depends on the year. So if you have $10,000 to invest, you can buy $100,000 worth of real estate. So if the property goes up 5% a year, you're getting 5% appreciation on $100,000. That's $5,000 a year. So you're getting a 50% return on your $10,000 investment. So that is the advantage of leverage. So if real estate is so great, why doesn't everyone invest in it? I'll tell you why, because it's a lot of work. Yes, you can get property managers, but I guarantee you, I've made this mistake. If you get a property manager, everyone except you gets rich. They have no motivation to keep the maintenance costs down. They have no motivation to get good tenants in there. They do the minimum work to get by because they're managing hundreds of properties. And you are the one left writing checks every month instead of getting checks every month. So, in my opinion, the only way real estate can make sense as an investment, if you're willing to be an active landlord, that means doing all the maintenance work. It means finding the tenants, screening them really carefully, you got to be willing to do all that. So it is a lot more work than the stock market and investing in that. If you don't want to do any work, invest in the stock market, because if you pay someone to do it for you, you're going to lose. So remember I said I lost my shirt in the stock market? I did. On the other hand, my real estate investments have done spectacular. So remember, I said you have to invest in things you understand. And I understood the real estate market here. Born and raised, understood all the neighborhoods, the rental prices, the economy. Silicon Valley was booming. Back then it was actually chip manufacture, which morphed into software and genetic stuff. And because we have two top-notch universities and all these high-paying jobs, these people have to live somewhere. And it was only a sign that rents and real estate prices were going to go up, and they did. So I bought two properties. The first was right when I graduated from college in 1984. I bought a townhouse for $125,000 at 12% interest. That's what it was back then. I had to get three roommates to pay the mortgage. But that's worth $1.25 million now. And that was on a $12,000 investment. So I did well on that. The house I purchased was $345,000, now worth $3.5 million. Again, tenfold increase on a $34,000 investment. It's done very well, but it's because I understood the market. So, is real estate a great investment? It depends on where you live, what the economic prospects of the area are, and how long of term you're looking to invest. Real estate can be an amazing investment for the long term. If you're willing to be an active property manager and handle all the tenant relations, choosing tenants, doing leases, doing all the maintenance, doing all the repairs, better yet, like I did, buy fixer-uppers and fix them up yourself, or build the house from scratch. That way you're guaranteed of instant equity. It's sweat equity, but it's equity. If you're looking for a passive investment, I mean, be honest with yourself. If you do not have time to do this stuff, then just invest in the stock market. Do dollar cost averaging, put so many dollars in a month, and be happy that long term it's going to work for you without stressing over another plugged up toilet at 8 p.m. on Sunday night. So that's it for my three-part series on how to invest. Hope it's been helpful. If not, I'll try again. Thanks for watching. Alfieder Zane.